Welcome back to the show, folks. We are here with Jason Torres, who is the founder and CEO of Beer Buzz. Now, it's spelled beer with a B-I-E-R.
Yep, the way it should be spelled, B-I-E-R.
Oh, is that how it's spelled? Where's that from?
No, Germany.
Ah, it's German. Yeah, I didn't know
that.
I thought it was just beer.
It's cool. Some people like to say Beer Buzz, so at least you pronounce it right, so that's kind of good.
I get paid well to try to pronounce things as
nice
as
we
possible.
Don't.
So you don't?
No.
We're here to help you out with all the viewers out here in Southern California.
Right on.
Well, thank you so much for being on the show. I know Beer Buzz is your child, basically.
Right.
You started it from the ground up. What motivated you to start Beer Buzz?
Realistically, I was just trying to get free beer. Let's be honest. I started about 4 years ago during the summer. And the idea was to do a show about beer and tech, just kind of have fun with it. I had no idea that the beer world was so immense. There's just so much to beer. I had no idea. So since I've been reading books, like nonstop, asking questions, the media side of us, we have a couple video and radio shows online. So we get to interview brewers. We get the intimate knowledge that other people sometimes don't get, which is kind of great. I honestly couldn't do this without like the team I do have, which are the phenomenal. We started doing events 2 years ago, which are kind of fun too. So, do you guys drink craft beer?
All the time.
Really?
Yeah. Not much, but I'm starting to get into it.
Okay.
So, what is the difference between craft beer and just other beer that you can buy?
A lot of times, see that's the thing. So, it kind of goes under definitions, I guess. What you kind of, for me personally, it's more of a handmade kind of a beer. There was a commercial that just came out not too long ago that a lot of people are kind of uproaring about. Anheuser-Busch put out, and I don't know if you guys have seen it, definitely check it out online. But for me, it's more of this small hometown kind of a feel. There's a bunch of local breweries here, like the new guys that just opened up Escape Craft Brewery. There's Ritual, there's Hangar 24, the guys Brew Rebellion right up the street. A lot of these guys, they put a lot of time into their beer. A lot of these guys and women, sorry about that. Lots of women beer as well. But it's great. They put natural ingredients. Everything you get into the beer is exactly what you're putting into it. It's really great. At least to me, craft beer is something that you take a lot of time and you make. It's almost like an art.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's definitely in the name of craft.
Right.
You're able to really input, that art and your perspective and the surroundings, you're able to have a lot of fun with what you brew.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times, and the thing is, too, a lot of these American industrial lagers, a lot of times, like Anheuser-Busch will put out Budweiser, you've got to remember the volume that they're making. The ability to actually reproduce that kind of beer at that volume is actually pretty awesome. It's not my style of beer, per se. I wouldn't really drink it. But it's just the ingredients that they do put in is going to be different from regular craft breweries.
And so your website offers a lot of different things. I know you said earlier you have videos, you do educational videos, there's a lot of great reviews, a lot of blog posts. Can you expand on that a little bit more for us?
Yeah, we have a couple different shows on the network, the Beer Buzz video show, which you absolutely have to watch.
Yes.
That's us pretty much drinking with the owners and the brewers talking about beer. We have Beer Geek Radio, which is just average guys talking about craft beer. And then we have the Craft Beer 102 show, which is actually pretty fun. That's where I get actually geek out and nerd out on the show. A lot of times people see me on the Beer Buzz show and I'm just always having fun, gregarious, just whatever. Craft Beer 102 is more of a, it's a way for us to actually see that we actually know what we're talking about. I'm actually the chairman of the LA International Beer Competition as well as a BJCP judge, so it's a little bit different, I guess. I love that show, so you guys gotta watch it.
Definitely.
Oh, yeah, of course. That's great.
When you started it, did you have any idea that it was going to grow into what it has?
No. Honestly, like I said, it was just supposed to be about beer and tech, and it just kind of snowballed, and now it's literally it's a beer network around beer. I'm telling you, if you guys get into beer itself, just craft beer, it's just going to be a nonstop hole. It's just going to you're going to keep going, and you're going to keep on seeing awesome, awesome things. I would recommend it.
That's great, absolutely, man. I love your enthusiasm. Yeah. I really do.
Great.
Especially with the craft beers and so many local breweries that are represented and that you mentioned the network and the events that you host. Can you tell us about those as well?
Sure. We actually have a couple of different events. On the event side, we do about 7 to 8 of them throughout the year. The one we have coming up March 14th is actually Shamrocked. It's our partnered event with X1039. It's going to be held at the Sam Manuel Stadium, which is awesome. The goal is to actually have it on the field. We'll see how that works. But it's going to be a lot of fun. We have over, 55 different flavors, which is going to be cool.
Wow.
A little over 30 breweries at the actual event. So $35, all you can drink. ShamrockBeerFest.com, if you like that.
That's not bad.
Very
so
cool.
tickets are $35, unlimited beer tastings, and do we get to meet you while you're there?
No. Yes, no.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll be running out with my head cut off, but it's going to be a lot of fun.
That's great. And I know the great race is on June 27th.
Correct.
Here in San Bernardino.
It is. We're estimating over 20,000 people are going to show up. We have a chili cook-off, a beer garden. They're estimating over 800 different classic cars, antique cars, I guess you would. Mm-hmm. I guess it depends what you want to call them, but they're going to be amazing cars. Patriots parade. There's going to be tons and tons of stuff. I would just recommend checking out our social feeds. Everything's just at Beer Buzz, spelled B-I-E-R. Easy. Get that right. But yeah, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Flickr, all that good stuff. Check it out. All the information will be on there.
Amazing events to look forward to. Yeah. And what a great thing to come to San Bernardino. You know, what a phenomenal event. And you're a big part of that. I mean, thank you so much. I mean, Jason Torres, this is your child, your brainchild, and it's doing so well, which is fantastic. And we all need to support him. So definitely check out beerbuzz.com, B-I-E-R.
Definitely.
German way.
Next time we'll just start drinking the whole time.
Yeah, we'll have to do some tasting.
Of course, yes. Maybe we need to go on your show, because here we're a little bit
that
restricted
on
what we can do.
We'll
but
do a little crossover.
I got a gift for you guys. You guys ready?
Yes.
Yes.
All right,
check
love
this
a
out.
Gift.
Pick a beer.
All right, I'm going to take the Big Deluxe. I'm so sorry.
I got the Einstock.
She's got the Einstock, folks. If anybody knows the Einstock.
You're in the 80s, right? I'm an 80s kid.
Absolutely.
You're in those Slappers fans. Yeah. Check this out.
What?
Yeah.
My TV
that
video.
Is cool. And
there you go.
It's like a Slapper Cozy.
Yeah,
fantastic.
It's a Slap Cozy. Those are pretty cool. And you can only buy those at beerbuzz.com, too.
All right, guys.
Another reason.
Beerbuzz.com. Jason Torres, thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks for having me, guys.
We'll be right back, everybody.
Hey guys, you enjoy that clip? Well, there's plenty more where that came from.
Click on that subscribe button and you won't miss a thing.
Oh, you know what we like to do.
We like to dance.